things just got real weird real fast. So I know that everyone is stuck home right now because of social distancing and coronavirus. And to be honest, my DMs on Instagram are blowing up because you guys have so many questions. You have so much anxiety about food, working out, all of the things that have to do with being stuck at home and thrown out of our usual routine. So I wanted to be sure that I answered all of those questions for you, and that's what I'm going to do in this video. I threw up a question box in my Instagram stories and asked you guys what your biggest questions, concerns were about social distancing and being stuck at home. So I've compiled your top 10 most common answers, and we're going to answer them rapid fire style in this video. So first off, I just want everyone to take a deep breath right now. Whenever we're emotional, stressed, anxious, whatever it might be, we're so much more likely to fixate on food, to fixate on our bodies, to try to nitpick ourselves, and that's not going to do anyone any good. We tend to do this because when things get chaotic or we feel like we're out of control, we tend to think that we can control our bodies, the things that we eat, all of those things. So it really works as kind of a coping mechanism. But doing that is not going to help the situation. Body dysmorphia gets worse. Food obsession gets worse. Compulsive exercise gets worse. So just take a second and breathe. Okay? Okay, let's get into it. Question number one that you have. What do you do if you just want to eat all day long? We're stuck at home, right? The pantry's right there. The fridge is right there. What if we literally just eat all day long? My recommendation for this is to try to stick to your normal eating schedule. Not saying you have to eat breakfast at a certain time, lunch at a certain time, but making sure that you make room for actually having meals throughout the day. Still make time for yourself to have breakfast. Still make time for yourself to have lunch. Give your body the nourishment that it needs. Sit down for it, actually put it on a plate, make it, like I said, kind of still in a routine, still kind of an event throughout the day, rather than just having it kind of mushed together. It's going to increase your enjoyment and your satisfaction of it. I also really recommend using the hunger scale. Now, I have a whole video that talks about how to use the hunger scale, what the hunger scale even is, so I'll link that up there for you. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but this is just kind of assessing, am I hungry? Am I full? And kind of identifying why your reasoning for eating is. Is it because you're hungry or is it just because you're bored? The next thing I recommend doing is assessing your emotions. Now we're gonna have a lot of these and they're probably gonna be all over the place. But again, kind of checking in with yourself and say, okay, if I'm not hungry right now, why am I going for the pantry? Is it because I'm bored? Is it because I'm stressed? Is it because I'm seeking comfort? Find out what that reason for you eating is. And if it is out of comfort or stress, ask yourself, okay, what can I do to help solve that emotion that I'm feeling or to cope with it? Now, don't get me wrong. If you are in a bad mood and you want to have a piece of chocolate to give you a pick-me-up, I do that too. That's no problem. But stuffing yourself with chocolate is not going to fix the issue at hand. I think that's the big thing with emotional eating and using food as comfort. It's normal to do that. I mean, we do that. If I'm having a bad day, I'm going to probably have a cookie to pick me up. Totally fine. But I'm not going to have 5 cookies in a row and expect it to fix my bad day. The root of the problem is still there. So ask yourself, what would help you fix this emotion? What would give you the comfort? What would give you the stress relief? Would it be journaling, calling a friend, whatever it might be? Assess that. I also have a full blog post on boredom eating and how to kind of go about that topic. So I'll link to that in the description for you guys and you can give that a full read. Okay, number two is what to do with the gyms being closed and exercise being way down. I feel you. I miss the gym. I miss my workout classes. I miss my friends in the workout classes. It sucks, but it's the card we've been dealt. Personally, I am trying to stick to my usual workout routine. I will do at-home workouts instead of, I'm not a big runner outside. Maybe I'll go for a run if I feel like it, but I'm not setting myself up for that expectation. I don't like running in the cold. It's kind of cold here, so I'm not going to force myself. Now, you can find tons of at-home workouts online. They're being posted all over Instagram, and they're so easy to find for free. You can go on Pinterest. I really love using Pop Sugar Fitness. Now, with this, some of their videos do have diet culture messaging saying, you know, burn the calories, you're going to burn X amount of calories. Personally, I have a filter for that stuff because I have built up what I call my diet culture suit of armor where I won't be impacted by that. But I think it comes down to really knowing yourself. If someone having that kind of language in a workout video would trigger you, don't do those kind of videos. I will say Pop Sugar has gotten a lot better at really being body positive and really working to not have that language in there, so you can find some of their videos that are free of that. But like I said, if your suit of armor is not as thick, just skip over the ones that talk about burning calories, because you don't need to hear that for 20 minutes, 15 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever length the video is. Now, on the flip side, it's okay to not work out as much, guys. You don't need to beat yourself up about that. Don't need to use exercise as a way to earn your food. You deserve to eat just by living. Remember that. So I'll be honest with you, yesterday I was like, okay, this is a good time where I can get some movement in. I went down to my basement and I was like, I don't freaking feel like doing this, so don't force yourself to do it. You have to have that flexibility, and really, honestly, I think we need to kind of shift our expectations. I am not going to get as great of a workout as I usually do over the next couple weeks, and that's okay. It's okay to be more sedentary in the season of our life. We've got bigger fish to fry. And no, I'm not saying, okay, stop working out, throw it out the window. No. What I'm saying is it's okay to have a preference of being active, of moving. But if you guys follow me, you know I say this. Think about the flip side. If you have a day where you can't get that preferred exercise in, would you freak out? Would you start to panic and be stressed and anxious? If the answer is yes, then it's likely that your preference for activity is not actually a true preference, it's a rule. And there, you might need to really start to work on that relationship with your body and exercise. Now, I totally understand this because I actually stopped exercising to really improve my relationship with exercise. And I have a whole blog post that I'll link to in the description that talks about my time not exercising. But this could be a really great time if you are struggling with your relationship with exercise, maybe doing some compulsive exercise, over-exercising, to use this time to really, really work on that. And I don't want anyone to feel like they have to do 4 workouts a day because they feel like they're being more sedentary. I've done that. I remember in college when we'd have snow days or the gym would be closed for whatever reason, I would feel like in order for me to earn my food and to be able to actually eat normally throughout the day, that would mean me doing like 5 different workout videos during the day. So I mean, you lose out on so much of your life. You cannot spend this whole social distancing time in your basement running in place. Don't do it. All right, question number 3 that you guys have is all about the urge to cut back on food because we are not exercising as much. Just don't do it. You deserve to eat regardless of if you've worked out that day or not. And we know when we are intentionally cutting back on food, when we are skipping carbs or skipping snacks, whatever it might be, don't intentionally do that. You have to fight that urge. Now, I do believe that our bodies are going to adjust, but it might not happen in a day, it might not happen in a couple days, but if we continue to listen to our bodies are going to adjust to different activity levels, and our hunger will respond accordingly. But we can't beat ourselves up for it not happening instantly. I mean, I always think about when I'm training for a race and then the race happens and you come off that training, my hunger doesn't just automatically resume to my pre-training needs. It takes time to adjust, and the same thing kind of happens here. Give yourself grace. Don't try to intentionally reduce anything. It's all going to be fine. You still deserve carbs. You still deserve cookies. You still deserve to eat, even if you just sit. Okay, number 4 is, how do we stop thinking about food all day long? So again, I have a blog post all on this topic. I'll link to it in the description. But I think the biggest thing is we have to make sure that we're giving our body enough food and enough of the right food. So making sure we're not skimping out on carbs, making sure we're giving our body adequate fat, because that's a hunger cue. If you are continually thinking about food, there's a chance that your body needs more or a different type of food. So like I said, I'll link to that in the description. You can give that a full read. But basically, that's, I think, the biggest point is make sure you're giving your body enough. Number 5, what do we do about being bored? So this one isn't necessarily related to food, but just I'm literally just bored being home. For me, I'm sticking to my usual routine, and I would really recommend doing that, trying to still have some sort of structure to your day. You can make a to-do list, things that you've been putting off. Oh, it feels so good when you get that stuff done. You can use this as time for self-care, read some books, spring clean, whatever. But I also want you guys to know that it's okay if literally all you do is survive day to day. I don't have kids. It's just me, the dog, and my husband. So I don't have to really worry about entertaining kids all day. I know that's something that's real for a lot of people is, okay, how am I going to keep my kids entertained? They don't have time to spring clean or to do the self-care or self-development that a lot of people are talking about. You should not have to feel guilty if that's you and you are just like, look, I'm just trying to get from day to day and keep my kids sane. Don't freak out that you're not doing all the self-development that you keep seeing all over Instagram. Another option is to bake. I've been doing a lot of this. I've been doing a lot of recipe testing for you guys, and I have a bunch of recipes that really are pantry staples. I don't cook very fancy. I don't bake very fancy. So I'll link to those in the description for you. Some of the ones that you guys love are my one bowl banana bread, cookie dough bites, chickpea cookie dough, snickerdoodle hummus. I have a couple different dinner recipes too. Easy broccoli chicken stir fry that's made from rice, chicken, and frozen veggies. So I'll link to those below. Give them a look. Number six that you guys are struggling with is mindful eating. And I think this one goes whether we're stuck at home or not. I have a blog post with 10 different mindful eating exercises for you. Again, I'll link to that in the description. But I think the biggest thing with mindful eating is I always say you should be able to describe your eating experience. You should be able to describe the food after you're done eating. So that means what did it taste like? What did it look like? What did it smell like? What was the environment like? Be able to explain that to someone. Super simple. And then you can also use the hunger scale. I usually say before, in the middle, and after your meal, just to kind of check in on that piece of it. And you can grab my hunger scale in my free ebook. I'll link to that in the description below. I'm stocking you guys up with resources. We need it. Number seven is, what do you do to forgive yourself if you did overeat? Guys, times are cray. Don't get upset at yourself. Like I said, it's normal for us as humans to want to turn to food for that comfort. So don't beat yourself up. And to be honest, I truly believe that we can learn from every single experience. So after maybe you've just emotionally ate cookies or you're like, oh, I'm so full, I was stress eating, whatever it might be, I usually say take to a journal and just kind of write it out. Try to see what can you learn from that experience. Maybe you learned, wow, I am actually really stressed and I was trying to cope with that through food. What is a more productive way for me to cope with my stress? Or maybe you realize I was not being mindful. Let me try one of the mindful eating exercises next time. Were you restricting and that caused you to overeat? How can you prevent yourself from restricting? Nothing is a failure. It's always a chance to learn. How can we deal with weight gain is number eight. Look, I'm going to be honest with you. My tummy feels softer than usual. My arms don't feel as strong. But let's be honest, we have bigger fish to fry right now. I like to remind myself that it's not permanent. This is just a season of our life. Nothing is really permanent, to be honest. Everything in life ebbs and flows, and we have to be flexible with that. And remember, our bodies can change, and that's okay. It does not change who you are. What I really suggest and what I like to do is to write down a list of things that you like about yourself that have nothing to do with your body. You can be kind at any weight, at any size. You can be motivated. You can be determined. You can be compassionate. You can be funny at any size. Even if we're feeling like maybe we've gained a little weight, maybe we're a little softer, whatever it might be, it does not change who you are. We are not defined by our bodies. Do some journaling around this. Write it out. See it on paper. Talk it out with a friend. So, so important. Number nine is, how do you deal with cabin fever? So I think that the biggest thing for this is to ask for what you feel like you need. For me, I usually work from home, but now my husband is working from home. So we have the two of us here. And it's really important if I just need some alone time for me to ask for that. Or if I need some other social interaction, FaceTime someone, call someone, find out what you need to help to prevent cabin fever and ask for it. No one's going to give it to us if we don't ask. And number 10 is, how do we cope with not eating healthy? So first of all, guys, all foods can fit into a healthy diet. And again, we have bigger fish to fry right now than eating refined white pasta versus whole grain pasta. It's fine. It's still nourishment. Don't stress over this. if you are really struggling with, maybe these are some of your food rules and you really are getting anxiety over having refined pasta or whatever it might be sure to grab a copy of my free ebook, The Ultimate 5-Step Guide to Finding Food Freedom, the exact steps that I've used to find it. That can help walk you through it. And also you can take the No Food Rules quiz, which will tell you exactly what is holding you back from breaking your food rules and give you a customized workbook to help you overcome that. I will link to both of those below for you. Okay, guys, that was a doozy. I hope that was helpful for you guys and just kind of relieves a little bit of your anxiety about this. Take a deep breath right now with me. Okay. Be sure to comment below with which tip is most helpful for you, or if you need any other suggestions, I'll do my best to answer them for you. And just remember, we are all in this together. Cue High School Musical montage? Just kidding. All right, guys, sending you virtual hugs. Hashtag social distancing. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe down there. Also, be sure to hit that little bell to be notified every time a new video is uploaded every Sunday. This one was just a little bonus. See you later.